Hi everyone, and thanks for checking out my channel. I'm gonna have a look at WTI crude oil today. Having a look at what happened for the last week, quote report, and also trying to see what could be a good trade for the coming week, potentially over the next two or a bit longer term. Let's get started. So having a look first at the chart and what happened with the quote report. So that's between the 12 and the 19, so it was a significant move up. And looking at the quote report, we can see a significant drop in open interest, and the managed money did actually reduce long position. Also, they reduced short as well. So that's going into the direction of sign that most of that move here we've seen from here to there to from 25 to 32. So significant move was mainly short covering, but actually not many longs added. So that's one point why I believe that that swing, that move up, might have actually reached the end. One argument, the open interest dropping is another one, which is 90,000. So that's significant. Let's take 90,000. So that's about 18k a day of reduced open interest, so significant. Now when we look at what happened on the days following the 19, we can see on Wednesday we had another about between July and August. So the other ones should roughly cancel each other, but we are roughly still above 7k open interest reduction. Same for Thursday on the 21st, we've got almost 10k. So we continue to reduce significantly, another 10k on Friday on that pace. So a bit less reduction, but that's probably because now the July contract is 100% active and the June contract expires. So I was explaining probably the lower open interest, but overall in terms of this, I'm not really confident that move we had here topping 33 was really actually such a strong move. Following this, we had a move up to 34, and now on the 4 hours chart, clearly diverging here. So I took that short trade from 34 and up down to 31 and closed that short. Took reverse to long from 31 and exited somewhere on 33 and didn't want to hold over the weekend. So successful trading for the last 2 days on my side. And what I'll be looking at now, so we have that trend line that we are spot on. It is on the more on the daily chart, so it's actually running slightly lower than this, but on the 4 hours it does adjust there. So we are really spot on that trend line, only 2 points of contact, potentially no a third one, so not highly significant. So we can still go break it and touch 35.5, which was the top inside the gap that we had between 41 and 32. So that area will be extremely important. What I'm looking for now is another divergence here, pushing to 65 and going to visit 35 here, about here, setting up a new divergence. It could actually come slightly a bit higher than this. We still have that divergence somewhere there. It doesn't have to be exactly on that trend line, but it could be somewhere there. I would offer again a nice short entry, and that time I believe we have a chance to go further down. I might not see that such a support at the 31 level. So be looking at this. Need to see some serious selling pressure coming here. I need to confirm the divergence here as well, because the trend is clearly up. It was not that strong in my opinion in the week before. still dropping open interest is also not a good sign for the continuation, but you need to be careful because there's still a fair bit of momentum here, so not actually trading against the trend, but rather catching some powerful move very quick, similar to that one. That was a really nice candle from 34 to 31, so that's what I'll be looking at, not something grinding inside that triangle, but something breaking strongly toward the support underneath. So I think 30 will be probably in support, which is the 50 MA on the 4 hours chart. So yes, quite important as well. Another thing just on the fundamentals, so leaving the chart for a moment, we've seen on the back of that move up a massive reduction in terms of the number of rigs in operation. So we are currently sitting about 300 or slightly more, which I think is the lowest since a very long time, back in 2009. Don't have the figure here, but it went down to 200, I think. So from above or near 1000 just earlier this year down to 300, that's a massive reduction, but only achieving about 1.5 reduction in terms of the production. So be very careful to have that number of rigs being too much of an expectation of a massive move up for the price, because the production is still very high. They can keep running these rigs and producing still significant volume. It's not crashing in terms of the supply yet, so a lot is on the demand. And also there, careful, because surely the lockdowns have been lifted in many countries, things are getting better, but still the demand is far away from where it was before the COVID-19. And even before COVID-19, we had a significant pressure in terms of the oversupply on the market. So yeah that's me on WTI for today. As usual, trade safe on this. Small position definitely better, stop loss on any position, that's a no-brainer at the moment. And if you are long on this, be careful, because the trend might be ending soon and reverse. And as usual with WTI, reversal are very sharp and can drop very quickly, so, and can happen in gap down, so even the stop losses might not actually work. So that's all. I'll have a look at this on midweek next week and see how we go. Did I take that short trade? It was successful or not? Or did we actually break higher and go to close that big gap here? Don't believe it will happen next week, but yeah, everything is possible. So have a look at this. I wish you a good week, safe trading, success, and I speak to you soon. Cheers, bye.